Welcome on Energetics TV. Today I'm gonna interview Benedict de Mulbeester about the European electricity markets. Welcome, Benedict.
Hello, Bart.
We noticed that the German coal 13 price is very low at the moment, mm-hmm. compared to the other countries in Europe. Can you explain something about it?
Yes, well, for example, if we have a look at last day's closing values, we are seeing that we had in Germany a 47.15 euro per megawatt hour price for the coal 13, mm-hmm. whereas in Belgium and the Netherlands we are seeing prices near 53, so it's a very significant 10% mm-hmm. Premium on the Belgian and the Dutch market compared to Germany, with France being somewhere in between these two markets.
Is this a new phenomenon?
No, it's not new. We've seen this in the past. Only what we see is that in the past 5 years, these different markets had started to converge more and more. They were really coming together. And now recently we see them diverging again, with the German market being markedly cheaper than the other markets.
What might be an explanation for this?
Well, it could be that this is due to the different supply and demand dynamics in the different countries, with Germany being flooded at this moment with renewable energy, which is pressing down prices. And in Belgium, for example, with the nuclear outages, there are worries over supply shortages. So this could be an explanation. You could also read a little bit the prices of the underlying commodities in these prices. The Netherlands is the highest price. Well, in the Netherlands, up to 80% of the electricity is produced with gas. And gas at this moment is relatively much more expensive than coal. Coal has come down. Prices of coal have come down in the recent months. And Germany is producing a lot more electricity from coal. So this could also be an explanation.
What might we expect in the future?
Well, the big question is, this diverging of these prices is showing that the interconnection of these electricities markets at this moment is far from perfect. Mm-hmm. So the first question is whether there will be measures taken to increase the capacities on the borders. And if this would happen, you would see that these prices would come closer to each other again. Mm-hmm. Of course, if this relationship between gas and coal prices would change again, we could also see a change of this pattern. And the big question is, will we really see problematic situations this winter in Belgium, for example, that could continue this pattern of higher prices in the Benelux?
Okay, thank you very much for the explanation.